Hello and welcome to this special episode of Storyboard. We're discussing the best ads of 2014, and it's not our idea of the best ads. It's the collective opinion of 19 of the senior most creatives in this country. To arrive at this list, we asked 19 creative directors, and I'm reading them out in alphabetical order. Arun Iyer from Law and Kenneth Saatchi & Saatchi, Arun Iyer from Low Linters, Ashish Chakravarti from Contract, Bobby Pawar from Publicis, Dhanji Wadia from Rediffusion, Josie Paul from BBDO, Karthik Iyer from Happy, Komal Sahal from Rediff, Malvika Mehra from Grey, MG Parmeshwaran from FCB because Chax had left, Prasun Joshi from McCann, Rajdeepak Das from Leobonnet, Rajiv Rao from Ogilvy, Raj Kurup from Creative Land, Rohit Ori from Dentsu, Russell Barrett from BBH, Santosh Padi from Taproot, Sonal Dabral from DDB, and Teesta Sen from JWT. We asked each creative director to recommend 5 ads created by some other agency and 1 ad created by his or her own agency. What you're going to see now is the top 10 ads of 2014 as decided by these 19 lists.
My name is Rishi.
No ullu banawing.
क्या मुंबई मुंबई रे नहीं है मैं मुंबई जा थू
खुदा तुम्हें सलामत रखे बेटा
ये बिल्कुल सही जवाब है आपका वर्ड प्ले
आज भी उतना ही गर्व और उतनी खुशी होती है
तरफ से दिवाली का बोनस मिला था तो मैंने सोचा कि हैप्पी दिवाली माँ
हैप्पी दिवाली बेटा
एक्चुअली मैडम एजुकेटेड लोगों को भी लगाना चाहिए काला टीका
ओह रियली
एक्सक्यूज मी
To discuss those 10 ads, the best ads of the year, I've got 2 very accomplished creative directors. I've got Rajiv Rao from Ogilvy and I've got Arun Iyer from Low Linters. Rajiv, I'll start with you. You look at all these 10 ads, there's only one commercial which is just a commercial, which is the Mumbai Mirror one.
Yeah.
Of the other 9, either they have extraordinary length, which is non-TV length, or they have a communication piece which runs a good cause, or they have both?
I think if you see in the past, like the advertising that we've been seeing has always been a short joke or, you know, something which was the regular advertising, you know, and there is a really a need to stand out and say something meaningful, something truthful. So a lot of brands are actually going out and trying to tell a big story, you know, trying to really touch people. And I think to do that, you need a length, you need a story that's very honest, that's truthful, you know. And I guess that's why you're seeing everything is about a cause, is about a feeling, a human emotion, you know. Or, so that's where it's all going towards. You know, I mean, you're seeing a lot of brands are actually saying, okay, that's enough of all this jokes or whatever, but let's say something meaningful. I guess that's what we are heading towards.
You know, Arun, is there a temptation then to not think of the traditional short 30-second kind of script and say, mm-hmm. no, let's do great causes? That's one. Two is there a danger you could force fit some good into a brand which can't really talk about that good?
Yeah, I think so. I think we can't, for the sake of it, say, okay, this is a cause we'll adopt with no connection with what the brand does or what the brand has a personality. And that personality and whatever cause the brand takes on board, there has to be a match. Otherwise, it doesn't work. And like Rajiv was saying, I think it's a time where brands are, the one-way street is over. You cannot communicate one way and expect, this is my message, take it or leave it. That's over. I think it's moved in the direction of, it's all brands have now, they've got to be part of conversation. And to be part of conversation, you either need to attach yourself with something that, and these are topics that people are interested in. These are topics that people want to talk about. So brands have no choice but to latch on to these things and fuel that conversation. Brands can only fuel conversation now. Brands cannot create conversation basis talking about itself.
Right. You know, but you know, we are talking 10 great pieces of communication, at least as defined by all of you. But for these 10, there are another 100. Absolutely rubbish pieces of communication, which obviously is based on a brief which said, make a long film, find a cause. Is that a pressure that creative directors are going to find?
Increasingly, and it's going to lead to a lot more trash. Let me be quite honest about it, because I think as advertising people, we have to stop taking pride in the duration of the commercial and start worrying more about what the commercial is about or what that piece of content is about. I think We cannot walk around the corridors of our offices saying, "Arey, I've done a 4-minuter, I've done a 5-minuter." It's useless. Because if you've done a 5-minuter and you're boring the hell out of somebody, it's a completely wasted 5-minuter. You'd much rather do a 30-seconder, be to the point and get it done with, is my opinion.
Okay. You were saying something.
I completely agree with Arun. I think, yes, there could be, a danger where, you know, every brief would be a 5-minuter. So I don't think, you know, like as he says, like the category, you can only do that with certain categories. Probably a small mint, you can't make a big story about it. You know, let it be a joke. It's not a big deal. It's not something that's going to change my life. So we need to be sensible enough to say, okay, this brief doesn't allow for a long film. I don't need to say something really big, larger than life. I don't need to touch people's heart or cord or whatever. So I don't need to do that. I mean, you know, let's let it be a 15-seconder or a 30-seconder or whatever. So I think we need to choose that. You know, it has to be something very relevant to that brand.
I think the principles of a commercial haven't changed. I think we have to be ruthless with our work. We can't get self-indulgent because there is no barrier on the duration. You know, that doesn't mean that we can get self-indulgent with it. We still have to engage people. It has, you know, you have to objectively take a call and say, this I think will bore people, this I think will engage people. I think engagement is very, and they have a lot more stuff to see, and we have to understand why we don't have a duration pressure now, because you can put it up on in a space where they have so much more stuff to see. You're fighting a lot more than television clutter now. You're fighting with all the social media of the world. You know, so you have to be very careful with it.
Yeah. Now, Rajiv, he talks about, you know, when you put it on social media and you're fighting with everything.
Yes.
Now, you've come, your agency, both agencies have come up with a number of pieces of communication with very long form, which doesn't even make it to TV.
Yeah.
If on TV, you know, just a token 1 day, 1 hour nonsense. Does that in turn put a lot of pressure on the creative director? Because now you're saying you got only 10,000 views and then you dance when it's 2 million. What happened? But most pieces of communication will fall in that. On TV, every piece of communication wasn't exciting.
Yeah.
You know, this YouTube only kind of measure.
Right.
As opposed
to
earlier, where the client spent 5 crores on mass media.
Right.
And therefore got seen.
I would say that, I think those numbers really don't matter. I would say, or YouTube figures or whatever. I think what we need to see is are people talking about it? You know, I think that's the best measure. Because you could probably see big numbers and maybe for whatever reason, but I'm saying it's it's about, are people really discussing, talking about your ad? Are people, you know, does that become part of the culture? I think that's the best measure for any brand or for any creative person.
Right.
I think earlier word of mouth was something we felt. Now we can see it. So with all the social media, you get a sense of whether your piece of communication, and I think there also there is a danger that I think our industry suffers from, is that we are so self-indulgent that we only worry about what our industry people are saying. I don't think that those 400 people make all the difference in the world, because we are experts at trashing each other. So I think that somewhere you get a sense of what the world is. What's the world's point of view on your communication, or a lack of point of view? You know that it's not really connecting the way you had probably intended it.
Right. Now tell me now, what is this new pressure that all of you as creative directors have to have 1 year to the ground to try and anticipate what society wants you to talk about tomorrow, what cause you should take up? You know, what kind of pressure is that?
So,
other than the obvious ones of corruption and so on, that's easy.
So, I don't think that there is pressure to know what society wants us to talk about. I think it starts from the brand. This is what the brand wants to do. In that context, is there a piece of conversation? Is there something from society that we can latch on to? And then, again, implement it in the context of the brand. It cannot be disconnected. And I don't want to take examples, but we know of causes where, you know, people have said, I will save the tiger, I will save trees, with no connection with their business or what the brand does. You know, that doesn't connect with people, because then it seems like a lip service CSR initiative. That doesn't really cut ice with people.
Rajiv, what do you think the marketer's role is in keeping calm and not saying, give me a viral piece of communication with a cause? I want a movement.
No, I think they need to not just jump into this trend, if I may call it a trend or whatever. They need to see what is right for the brand, you know, whether it's like, again, as I was saying, it all depends on what category, what is your brand all about. So as Arun was saying, it has to be relevant. If you're talking about a cause, even if you want to take a big cause, it has to be relevant to the brand. It has to come from the brand, what the business is all about. It can't just be completely something you just take a cause. And fine, you can do that, but that's not going to do anything for the brand. You know, you can do something independently, whatever, a CSR activity. But that is something that you do because you want to do it, as the brand. The brand wants to do it. It's not going to help the brand. It's not going to change the image of the brand in that way.
Right.
But I also feel, Anand, that there is too much being made out of causes. I don't think that cause is the only way to generate conversation.
Right.
Even in the examples that we are talking about today, a lot of it is just pure entertainment. And people, or it's left, or if you take the Nescafe piece, it's left people feeling inspired a little bit. It's not necessary that it's a cause. So, you know, it's not that cause is the only way to garner conversation.
Right, right. So, the ability to entertain over a longer span, if it can hold the viewer for that long.
To make them feel in whichever direction you want them to feel. At times you could want them to laugh, at times you could want them to feel a little touched, at times you could want them to feel inspired. That depends. That depends on what the intention of the communication is. But as long as it's genuine and it comes through and then people feel it, then it takes its own
life. Right. Staying with this, Nescafe, what does it do for the brand? Here, there's a stand-up comedian who's had a speech impairment. And where's the coffee signal or the brand signal that comes out of it?
Yeah, I think that towards the end when he talks about the fact that it all starts here, I think they've taken that platformic thought of theirs and we've done interesting story around it. It is not as well branded as a lot of the other communication is, but because it has it connected with people, I think the brand kind of people remembered the piece of work and in association with the brand.
Okay, now you know the Nescafe piece, and then coming to one of your pieces, which is the Google piece, does it take a very brave marketer to say, to jump and say, hey, this works for my brand, even if it is not direct A for Apple kind of connection?
No, absolutely. I think, again, Google, for instance, I guess it's just a beautiful story. That's something that any marketer would jump into and say, okay, I would love to do it. But I think definitely there is very few of them who would say, yes, I want to put my name on it.
Right.
And I think Google has a stature as a brand. It has the stature because it's now part of the Indian culture. You know, it's part of our lives. So I guess that makes most sense. I think for Google to give this message. So it's yes, it may be nothing to do with what they do, but I guess it has earned that stature to say, okay, please go and vote.
Right. You know, Arun, from another common thread, lot of these ads don't say anything about the brand, and there's no product window. Perhaps there's a bit of a logo somewhere. You know, it's a new world, no? Where from clients saying make my logo bigger to say make sure you have 2 seconds for the product window. It's not establishing.
So it is. It is. So, in fact, I remember a conversation, and since Kisan is in the mix, I remember a conversation with the Kisan client where we were in the meeting and I was pushing for, you know what, no, actually that bottle of Kisan should appear here, and the client was pushing back, saying, you know what, don't worry about the Kisan branding and stuff like that. I really want this thought to connect with people. It was a strange sort of meeting, but it was true. I think because the fact that, I think we've all come to recognize the fact that the lesser branded that it is, the lesser hard sell it seems like. Right. That doesn't mean that, you know, we have to unbrand everything, but it's the attempt is to, and it's all an attempt to be genuine about whatever it is that you're trying to do. And in that genuinity, the more you plug, the more you hard sell, the more people switch off from you, is my understanding.
Yeah. And you, for the same thing, the product window and the logo, where's that going? Where's that headed?
Look,
you can't imagine selling these pieces of communication 15 years ago.
Absolutely, absolutely. No, I think I think that the whole thing about, you know, make the logo bigger, I think that doesn't make any sense anymore. Because I think now it's clear that you connect with people, tell them an engaging, give them a story which they love. They will know the brand. You know, it doesn't matter. I mean, even if you put a 1 second slate at the end, they'll know, okay, this is the brand that was, as long as it's very relevant to, the story is relevant to the brand, people will remember, people will connect. So, as you were saying, I think it's not about just shoving it down the throat, you know, just the more you do that, you know, it just looks fake. It looks like, you know, you're trying to, I guess people are smart. I think the consumers are very clever. They can see that fake advertising or advertising. They don't want to see advertising anymore. They want to just see stories and brands telling stories rather than just being an ad.
Now tell me, while all this is happening in the TV space, the audiovisual space, in print it remains exactly where it was perhaps 15 years ago. You know, big logo, lots of hard sell, lots of rubbish lines. So what is this dichotomy? How can you have, you know, TV communicating in one way and print communicating completely? Yeah. Same consumer seems to be the same.
Yeah. Print as a medium has not evolved. I mean, print is print. I mean, you know, it's
what
really...
What is the responsibility of the communicator to say, I'll make print ads look different now?
It has not evolved. It's been the same. I agree. Probably you've gone down, worse. It's just pure information. It's no, print is very expensive. You know, you can't reach out to everyone. I can send a WhatsApp message and that the whole world will see. But I can't do that on print. So I guess it's something that's a must when you have to say certain things. So it's become a boring medium, boring way of communicating. Whatever it is, you just take the smallest size and just make sure that
When is the last time you worked on a print ad?
I don't remember.
Arun, when is the last time
I work quite often on print ad. Right. So because we do have clients like Economic Times and stuff, so we work on print. But hand on heart, I think we're all to blame. I think we don't push back, we don't fight as hard for that medium as we do for, and I don't want to call it TV, for video.
Right. That's why I said audiovisual is what I said.
Yeah. So we don't fight as hard for the print medium, because I think that as advertising agencies, I think there is so much energy that goes behind trying to figure this animal called digital, trying to do well on the audiovisual front, that I think by the time it comes down to print, the battle's lost. So I think we are all to blame. I don't think any of us push hard enough on that front.
Okay. Right. Last question to both of you. Start with you, Rajiv. So what are we going to see in 2015? I mean, we have seen some clear trends in 2014. Yeah, yeah. What are we going to see in 2015?
No, I hope to see more of great stories. And I hope I don't see any of forced stories which are long for the sake of being long. That's about it.
I think this long format is here to stay. I think it's been around for a while. I hope, like Rajiv was saying, that we don't get carried away with this long format stuff. And I have a feeling that we will, my gut feel is that in this year, we will see a breakthrough on digital. Some brand is going to do it. It's a sitting duck. It's waiting to happen. Something is going to happen this year, is my sense.
Thank you, Arun. Thank you, Rajiv. So that's a wrap. And we've discussed the finest ads of 2014, as decided by 19 creative directors of the country. Interesting that we close with, you know, Arun saying that perhaps we'll see a digital breakthrough. Long form is here to stay. And next week, when we come back with our regular episode of Storyboard, we'll show you short form, one new commercial. Thank you so much.